God can lift you and launch you from wherever you are if you're obedient. Moses was in the middle of Midian. No one was there. He lifted and launched him. Jesus is from Nazareth, a nowhere town, nobodyville. And he brought the Savior out of nowhere. We can go over and over and look in scripture and find that God chooses to do supernatural lifting and launching from the most obscure places. In 2023, it's not about shouting on Sunday. It's about winning on Monday. 12 months of opportunities. Everything in your life has led you to this moment. Launching, being lifted. And I've never seen a rocket with a rearview mirror. I'm not looking back. We have liftoff.
Ready for the word? Let's go to Luke chapter 4. Again, we want to welcome our visitors, those who might be watching for the first time across all of our online platforms from ourrelentlesschurch.com. Shout out to everybody that's in the chat feed. I love to go to ourrelentlesschurch.com and look at the chat feed and see people throwing up praise hands in the chat feed and encouraging one another and praying for one another. To our YouTube Live and our Facebook Live, and to those who watch via our app, it means the world that you lock in to the word and into the worship. Today filled me up because every time I see a choir, it just reminds me of the beauty of the volunteer heart of the church. See, when I was growing up, we sang every Sunday. Now, I never saw a check. I don't know if you did, but I was glad to sing because I got to sing for the Lord. You understand what I'm saying? And I'm not knocking, nor should you knock, those who do this professionally and this is how they earn their living. But I'm talking about a choir of 100, 150 people every week just singing in that hot robe, and we serving God. And then somebody got them church mints that make all the noise. I miss those days. I really do. It's amazing what God is doing at Asbury. Is it Asbury College in Wilmore, Kentucky? Apparently, there are other reports of revival. And I love that. Reports of revival. It's amazing. I'll tell you something else. We need revival. When Los Angeles had a blizzard warning, I'm talking to somebody. When LA has snow on the Hollywood sign, Jesus is on his horse about to come back. Stop playing with God. I'm gonna say this again. Turkey had an aftershock, 6.2. There are still people under the rubble they won't find for months. They said over 6,000 structures fell to the ground. There won't 6.2 aftershocks. God is shaking the earth. Wait, hold on. The Bible says the earth is groaning with birth pains. Let me rephrase. God is not shaking the earth. The earth is shaking, waiting for the sons of God to be revealed. That's Romans 8, 18 and 19. For I consider that the sufferings of this present age are not worthy to be compared with the glory that shall be revealed in us. For the earnest expectation of the creation eagerly awaits the revealing of the sons of God. That means the mountains are waiting on the sons and daughters of God to get in place. Religion can't get you there. Relationship will. I'm in Luke chapter 4. I'm at the 16th verse. I'm reading from the New King James Version. So Jesus came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up. And as his custom was, he went into the church, the synagogue, the gathering place, on the Sabbath day, the Shabbat, which is Saturday in the Hebrew. Sunday is the Lord's Day. For those who do not understand why we worship on Sunday, it is the day that we commemorate the resurrection of Yeshua HaMashiach. If we were Jewish, then we would worship on the Sabbath, which is Friday night to Saturday night, sundown Friday to sundown Saturday. But the Bible makes clear, and you can read Galatians, you can do this on your own, but we are not subject to the law. We are informed by it, but we were never invited to it. We are not Jewish. We were grafted in. Gentiles grafted in. Faith in the promise through Abraham. Help me, Holy Ghost. And so I'm giving you some theology. So when people, why you go to church on Sunday? It's the Lord's day. He got up on Sunday. So the least I can do is get out of my bed and go to the church. If he got up, so can I. Oh, that's good. And he was handed the book of the prophet Isaiah. And when he had opened the book, he found the place where it was written. I need y'all to stay with me on this. This is a big deal. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Why? Because he has anointed me. This is a staggering, declarative, truth statement. The reason why the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Why? Because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. Then Jesus closed the book and gave it back to the attendant and sat down. And the eyes of all who were in the synagogue were fixed on him. Look at your neighbor, tell him everybody's about to be looking at you. They didn't believe you. Find somebody else. Because what God's about to do in your life is so crazy. They literally going to stare. They won't have anything else to say. Find somebody else. Tell them everybody's going to be looking at you. Somebody caught it. Everybody's going to. You didn't ask for it. You were anointed for it. So they have to look. Don't get insecure. What you looking at? They're looking at the anointing. They've never seen it. They don't know what it's like. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me. Let's stay right there, elder. Very important. He has anointed me. We are in the Lift and Launch series. The title of the message is Oil Check. Tell somebody, check the oil. Go ahead and be seated. I think y'all feel it like I feel it. Elder Lord, it's going to be one of them ones. You might should have put on your gym shoes this time. All right, you got flats on. The days of playing games in church have been over, but they are over now. With people dying, lost, with a society that is more bold in their hatred towards God and the things of God. When wrong is celebrated and right is vilified. When your faith is made a mockery of. But if you say anything about anybody else, they gonna march, protest, and do every other thing. But y'all can talk about my Jesus all day and nobody does anything. We need an oil check. In a day when speakers talk from their insecurity, and not from the word, we need an oil check. When popularity is more celebrated than humility and consistency and holiness, we need an oil check. When people have attended church for years but have never seen a real miracle, we need an oil check. Somebody say, check the oil. The church is not a place for games. The church has a social component. There is a part of this that is community oriented. Forsake not the assembling of yourselves together. Fellowshipping, very important, but it is not the singular primary function of the church. The primary function of the local church is to be a gathering place for like-minded believers to receive the word of the Lord and then deploy into a world that hates it but needs it. Say that again. They can't stand you, but they need you. So some of the people that can't stand you, those are your assignments. I'm helping somebody because you're like, God, why you keep bringing this so-and-so? She's like, right. And God was like, because you're assigned to them. Nobody else will be able to reach them. That's why I've called you to it. Check the oil. Oh, Lord. My Jesus made it clear after he had gone through his process of development and preparation. He then gets baptized by his cousin John, comes out of the water. The Holy Spirit descends upon him in the form of a dove and alighting upon him. And a voice from heaven ratifies this moment. So you see the triune Godhead, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And the Father says, this is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. And from that moment on, Jesus began to preach, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. We don't have enough preachers screaming the same thing that Jesus was screaming. We don't have a church that will receive sound doctrine. We are in an age of super popular, make me feel good, give me what I want, or I'm going somewhere that will tell me what I need to hear. And you will be ear hustled all the way to a hell that you were never supposed to be in, because itching ears, the Bible says, they don't want to hear sound doctrine. They don't want to hear that there's a standard, and holiness is still the standard. They don't want to hear repent, turn. They don't want to hear that you can change. They don't want to hear that sin is why Jesus died. And if you have any in your life, you need to confess it and get it out of your life. And then get accountability in your life so that you don't let that thing back in your life to destroy your life. I'm talking to me. You can clap if you want. But I'm tired of the Lord's church looking weak and impotent because we sing and we dance and we shout, but nothing changes. I've been around people, man, seen them my whole life, will speak in every unknown tongue you ever heard of. No power to live a holy life. Be in church every week. Still mean, ornery, unkind, judgmental, no love, no care, won't give to the poor, won't even return their mama's phone call. And you think God is okay that you came in here with a fancy hat, but your character hasn't changed? When the church tolerates mediocrity when it comes to the people that preach the word and disseminate the worship, when you know they're not living right, but you let it go because as long as they talented, we might as well go ahead and keep them. Nobody's perfect. I know we're not perfect, but the standard has not changed. Oh, I'm gonna preach it till the remnant gets it. Help me, Holy Ghost. There is an anointing for this. Somebody reached out and said, Pastor, I feel like I'm called to preach. My first reaction was to type run as fast as you can, as long as you can, as far as you can, Jonah. But even then, there'll be a fish to swallow you. Even if you're trying to die, you can't even die right. They throw you off the boat in a storm. You should be dead in the next 30 seconds. God got a big old fish just whoop, sitting in there for 3 days and spits him out at his assignment. Uh-oh, something just shifted. I felt it. You've been running and the Lord still spit you out on the shore of your assignment. Oh, my God. Tell somebody, oil check. Some of these people that you're trying to run from, they're your assignment. So go ahead and embrace it. Ooh, this is good. Jesus, here's the thing about Jesus. He was a man, but he was not man-made. Let me make this clear. This is what Hebrew says. There's only one mediator between God and man. It is the man, Jesus Christ, capital M-A-N. Giving you theology for the ones who want it this morning. By the way, on a side note, most people come to church to observe or to check off a box of religiosity that I went to church. Well, what did Pastor John say? I don't know. He had on a red sweatshirt and he was sweating like he always does. I'm not really sure what he said. The title is Oil Check. At least get that part right. You're talking to somebody who helped to perpetuate an economy in the kingdom that was based on transactional sermons. They would fly me in because my name sold registrations. That's what church people use instead of tickets. I can't stand church, but we so churchy. Get your registration. It's early bird registration. Fool, it's a ticket. We call it registration because to call it a ticket would show you what it really is. Entertainment. I'm going for blood today. Okay, Mr. Organist, so lock in, okay? Because I'm getting ready to go crazy. I've only had a couple hours sleep, so I have no filter. You can judge me if you want. I promise you, I'm gonna say everything that's in my mind. I think God is sick and tired of people putting his name on stuff that he had nothing to do with. I recently had a friend whose niece was killed on the Michigan State campus. Was killed in that shooting a couple weeks ago. And people like, well, you know, I know y'all loved her, but God loved her best. Would you please shut up? God had nothing to do with that. I need everybody to get this in your spirit. Stop blaming God for stuff that people did. We have free will, and people make terrible, horrible decisions. But the sovereignty of God says all things are working, even if they don't make sense. No, he did not will for that girl to be killed. He did not choose for that to happen. We have done horrible things to one another. But it ain't his will. Stop putting his name on it. Stop giving God credit for stuff the devil did. Get mad blaming God for stuff. You chose him. God, my life is a living hell. It's your fault. You chose her. Now you mad at him. Ain't no different than Adam talking about this woman you gave me. Take responsibility. Face it. It's real quiet in here because some of y'all are like, he talking about us. He talking about us. Don't do that right now. We don't have no counselors for you. You come to the altar in about 15 minutes. She was like, I'm leaving. This is crazy. I am out of here. I am Tell somebody, check the oil. God wants his church back. And there's going to be a distinction, Elder Burnside, between entertainment-driven, political tomfoolery and the true church of Jesus Christ. Does God work through culture? Absolutely. Anybody who says God doesn't see color is misinformed or outright telling a lie. God made every color, every ethnicity, every culture. I didn't say race because race is a construct that is man-made. There is no such thing as different races. There's the human race. We have different physical characteristics, but there's only one human race, which is why the enemy, I can't even believe, I'm sure he's shocked that racism worked. Because when you're an idiot like the devil is, you start with your lowest attack and then try to go up. He said, well, let me see if I can separate them by the way they look. And it works. That's why it matters. A multicultural church matters. Where you honor people that don't look like you because they were created by the same God as you. You can go ahead and give him a praise right there. And many of the people who say they don't see color, and I've been in the rooms. I've been at all the popular white evangelical churches, and I was the safe black guy that they brought in to appease their crowd. And the truth is, my blackness was welcome because I'm anointed to reach people from all races. That's just who I am. But the challenge I have is if you want to get honest about who Jesus is, and we say color doesn't matter, but if his hair is like lamb's wool and his skin is like bronze, and the earliest pictures of Jesus and Mary was this color, but those paintings were put away for the picture of the baby with a halo. For those who don't know, the halo is the removal of the afro. Go study it. I'm not trying to tell you Jesus is black, but I'm trying to tell you that people say color doesn't matter, but if it doesn't matter, then put the picture up that the Bible says. Or stop lying, saying it doesn't matter, and say it does matter. Because people have used color to keep us divided in the church. And now they put politics on front of Jesus like he's a Republican or a Democrat. He's neither. He's a king. And kings do not vote. They decree. I need everybody in this place to give the Lord a 7-second praise break. No, that's an applause. I said give the Lord a praise break. I need you to go ahead and look at somebody, tap your chest, look at somebody, say, God anointed me. It's not my fault. Nick, it's not my fault. I didn't anoint me. I got 5 points. I want you to grab it. It's not my fault. I don't know why you're mad at me. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me. I did not anoint me. You can tell people who are self-anointed. Oh, help me, Holy Ghost. They tear down everybody else. They're the only way. If you listen to anybody else, you either going to hell or there's going to be a curse or a demon's going to show up. And so they use manipulation and fear and intimidation to keep you connected to them. That's a cult. The reason why you can trust the anointing on my life is because I love God more than I love you. Because if I love you more than I love God, I'll do anything to keep you. but you can't save me. You can't deliver me. You can't answer one prayer, but I want you to write this point down. Number one, there are people that men appoint, and there are people who God anoints. Psalm 92 and 10 says, but my horn you have exalted like a wild ox. I have been anointed with fresh oil. This was King David. He said, I've been anointed with fresh oil. Somebody say fresh oil. Listen, don't come into this pulpit with stale oil. And I'm not just talking in this pulpit because y'all know stale oil don't even work here. If you don't have no oil, you're going to get embarrassed coming up here. Because this here, we get fresh bread. I play zero games when it comes to this word. Let me tell you, so I wish there was a preaching Olympics for my generation. I'd get the gold medal because I play zero games. I ain't afraid of no. Put me up against whoever you want. If it was a competition, I'm going to preach that word. I'm going to lift Jesus up. And I'm never going to ever dishonor the holiness or the preeminence of Jesus Christ. Y'all know what it is when I get the mic. Somebody say fresh oil. Somebody say fresh bread. But there are some people who go to the same church every week and hear an iteration of the same sermon over and over again. They hung him high and they stretched him wide. Yeah, he hung his head for me. He died early Sunday morning. He got up with all power. That's amazing. But 17 weeks in a row? I'm gonna get on out your way. Please do, hurry. How many people thank God for fresh oil? The people that men appoint are the people that men can control. If men put you in, they can take you out. There was an opportunity that was presented to me some years ago by some trustees of a particular church. And there was a pastor who was already in place. And they said, if you say yes, we're going to let him go. And the opportunity was a significant opportunity. And the Holy Ghost was like, know this, whatever they do to him, they'll do it to you. Let me tell you something, because the enemy will offer you what's yours prematurely. And God wants to see if you're gonna do it his way. Or the devil's way. I'm trying to help somebody in here. Let me tell you something. It's yours, just not yet. Oh my God, put it in the chat feed. Rob, get this on camera. It's yours, just not yet. Because if he gave it to you now, it would kill you because you don't have the character to sustain what he wants to give you. Come on, David. He was anointed at 13, but it took 17 years till he got the kingdom. Tell somebody, I'm going to go ahead and use what you said, Pastor. Don't rush the process. Don't let men or women get you out of position. You know, you should start your own church. I don't know nobody like you. They gassing you. They gassing your head up. And you sitting up so insecure, you listening. I think I'm going to start me at work. Are you crazy? You know how many devils are excited about you getting out of the will of God? Don't let people appoint you because they will disappoint you. I'm preaching better on my first point. There are people that men appoint and there are people who God anoints. And the ones that God anoints don't need permission from you to do anything God told them to do. uncompromising voices who don't need to be popular because they care more about obedience than being celebrated. Oh, God, help me. Oh, Lord, somebody say, check the oil. What I love about Jesus in the scripture that we were reading in Luke chapter 4 is that he made it very clear. God anointed me for a specific thing. So I need you to know that your oil is real, but it may not translate to every area. It's real quiet. What do I mean? Your oil is specific to your assignment. This is good. See, Elder, when you come up to pray, I know that you have an anointing, a faith, right? A gift of faith to pray people into the will of God, the purpose of God, and to unlock the provision of God. You have an anointing for that. What's Mama Glenn? Pastor Glenn? Down the street, Pastor Glenn, she's anointed to pray. When she prays, heaven moves. I'm trying to tell you something. Find you somebody that's anointed, because the anointing is not the same as being appointed. They wanted Saul, and that's who they got. Then God said, it didn't work like I told you it wouldn't. And he said, Samuel, go to Bethlehem. I have provided for myself a king. Some of y'all been on the backside of a valley singing songs nobody heard, praying prayers that nobody hears. And God says, I can trust her. I can trust him because they worship me when no one's around. They sing to me when there are no cameras. They serve me when no one is looking. Am I talking to anybody here or online? Stand up in your house. Stop playing. Don't make me come to the house. Tell somebody, check the oil. I love Jesus because we understand that he was doing what he was assigned to do. Number two, very important, the anointing does not address character. We're going to stay right here for a second. The anointing does not address character. There's a scripture in 2 Samuel 1. So David said to him, to this man who killed King Saul, how was it you were not afraid to put forth your hand to destroy the Lord's anointed? Then David called one of the young men and said, go near and kill him. And he struck him so that he died. You're like, well, how does this go with this? Let me help you to understand. David was anointed to be king after Saul. But he understood that God had anointed Saul. So he couldn't put his hands on the Lord's anointed to get what God promised. Just because you next up don't mean you get to put your hands on who's up now. Y'all playing with me. I love y'all, but that was one that was, I needed a couple people to jog on that, but just because you know you up next doesn't give you a right to start being Absalom. Whispering the other, you know, he all right, but you know, I'm up next. You know what I care. You know what it is. Let me tell you something. There were wicked people who meant well when I was serving Pastor Joel in Houston. Oh, my God, look at all the people. Here's 10,000 people. You should start a church. I said, why would I ever dishonor the anointing that I'm under when he brought me here to serve his vision? Well, why don't you do, oh my God, I'm gonna go ahead and just keep it really 1,000. So many opportunities came to me during my time at Lakewood. First African-American to consistently preach every single week in the history of that church. Seeing unprecedented numbers. It was a perfect opportunity for business. And God said, preach the word. Anything else? No! Just preach. And that's what I did. Every week. Faithful. And every time somebody tried to whisper in my ear, I knew it was the enemy trying to see if I had taking the Kool-Aid of popularity over obedience. Because character is what you are when no one is looking. I could have put out a book every 6 months. I could have started 5 academies and 15 different initiatives, and none of it would have had the breath of God on it, because my assignment was to serve. David's character would not let him rejoice in the death of his spiritual father. He called Saul my father. Even though Saul tried to kill him with a spear, he tried to kill him. And David said, I'll still respect his anointing. That's why I'm careful what I say about those who are anointed. But then I also hold nothing back when you ain't anointed, but you lying about it. I ain't playing no more. If you ain't anointed, I'm going to tell my, don't listen to her. Don't listen to, that's the flesh. That's a, they are not anointed. Everybody who preaches is not anointed. Everybody who pastors is not anointed. Everybody who evangelizes is not anointed. Some people. Listen to me. The anointing does not address character, which means you have to. Let me tell you something. I know what it's like to be anointed and unsubmitted. Use whatever excuse you want. But God is not playing games with the body anymore. Just because you're anointed doesn't mean you get to live how you want. Do what you want. Say what you want. Treat people how you want. That is a lie. Holiness still matters. Integrity still matters. Character still matters. Sexual purity still matters. Well, Pastor, haven't you struggled? I've struggled my whole life. It doesn't change the standard. The standard doesn't change just because you struggle. Struggle, but the standard is still here. If you fall, get up. Get up. Get up. Turn from your wicked ways. I need everybody in here to give God a praise. This is not a game. I need some intercessors praying. I told them I'm having a couple of little pains, but I'm not stopping. I got to finish this word. You understand me? Because we've seen too many gifted people and talented people who do what they want because you're anointed for a particular thing and you think you can live how you want on the other side, and the devil is a lie. You better get real about this thing or God's gonna take you out of here. Oh God, the anointing does not address character. So you have to. That means you gotta find people that won't let you fall off and stay there. Oh, y'all don't hear me in here. Man of God, you need somebody to get in your face. Hey, what you doing? Where you at? What you been watching? What you been checking? What you been looking at online? Not in your regular browser, on that other browser. Yeah. What'd you say, the private browser? Yeah, what's going on with the private browse? See, because that means I love you too much to let you go to hell. So I'm a fight for you. David had a whole lot of trouble, lot of struggles. But he had friends. See, Samson was anointed, but he had no friends. That's how you can have all that strength and give your secret to a witch. You that anointed that you can kill 1,000 people with the jawbone of a donkey? but she can lull you to sleep on her knees. And here's what's deep. His character was never addressed with his mama and his daddy. They were like, well, Samson, don't you want to get one of the women from Israel? No. Give me one of them Philistine freaks. She's freaky. I like her. You need to study it. He liked freaky women. Here's what he should have said. God, I want a saved freak. Can we please be honest in here? This is why people end up messing up their whole life. I want you saved in here. But when we leave here, look back at it. When we leave here, be what I need you to be. Don't speak in tongues here. Use your tongue, but don't speak in them. I'm trying to help somebody because the enemy's coming after marriages, and he's got you thinking that what you need is not in your house. Somebody say, check the oil. God is serious about holiness. You single? Well, I'm single. I got needs. Everybody got needs. He doesn't deserve your womb if he doesn't give you a covenant promise. He took you to dinner and you giving him. Well, we in love, we gonna get married anyway, so if we getting married, then you can wait. And if you can't wait, then you probably lying. Is this good preaching? Point number three, talent and gifts are not the same as the anointing. Everybody get this in your spirit. Talent and gifts are not the same as the anointing. What does that mean? Just because somebody can sing doesn't mean they're anointed to destroy the yoke off your life. You're talking to somebody that put together five or six amazing, gifted people who were very well known on a platform. There's nothing wrong with collaboration. But if you ain't anointed, put the mic down. See, because talent is why the body of Christ is so weak now. Talented preachers, talented speakers, know what to wear. Let me tell you something. Don't ask me fashion, nothing. My wife has to tell me, you have on six colors. Where are you going? How long you been doing that? 12 years? How long we been married? 12 years? So pretty much the whole time. Yeah. I've looked at a picture that I took out on Valentine's Day. I don't even know where I got this shirt. It was a Mexican matador shirt. The collar came all the way up here. Bright blood, vampire blood red, black velvet swirls. When I walked in, it was like, na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na. No, 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 no. I was so proud of that terrible shirt. I looked at that picture and then I saw other ones. Terrible pattern jacket with wide leg True Religions and some goofy brown boots. And I was just. But I can preach. I ain't no fashion, whatever. Talent and gifts do not scare devils. Find me a singer who can run all up and down the scale, that's great. But find me somebody who's been with Jesus. And that's who's gonna literally declare a sound that heaven rides on. I said talent and gifts are not the same as the anointing. So you need to ask the Holy Spirit for discernment. Somebody say, give me discernment. How many people are so hungry for popularity and applause that they lay the anointing down so that they can be celebrated by people? Oh, Lord. Lord, help me. Talent and gifts are not the same as the anointing. And you need to ask for discernment. Number four, let's move fast. I'll let you go. The enemy is only subject to the anointing. The enemy doesn't have to respond to your talent. I wish you would sing to a devil, "Devil, come out of there. I bind you in the name of Jesus." He was like, "Negro, please." Try to sing a devil out, and you have no oil, you ain't spent no time in prayer, you don't have no history with God, and you got the nerve to try to stand up in front of a real devil with no oil. I said the enemy is only subject to the anointing. You don't believe me? Go to Acts chapter 19, the 11th verse. Now, God worked unusual miracles by the hands of Paul, so that even handkerchiefs or aprons were brought from his body to the sick, and the diseases left them and the evil spirits went out of them. From a handkerchief. He was not there. What he had in his hand was there. Oh, that we would have that kind of oil in this season of revival. Help me. And the Bible says, then some of the itinerant Jewish exorcists took it upon themselves. They missed it right there. The moment you take it upon yourself, God was like, "I'm out." He'd be like, "Angels, mount up." You mounted up. It was a clear black night. Sitting right here on Halloween on a mission trying to find the G-O-D. Angels, mount up. This is not in my notes, but I'm going with it. The fact that you have that in your keyboard, oh, the fact that y'all know this song lets me know we gotta pray for you. Clear black night. People be playing this devil is real. Trying to get sick, some folk is ill. That's why you gotta stop and play the hill, cause Jesus Christ, he died on the hill, but his blood translates. You can get saved. Stop playing games. Time to behave. Stand up on your feet with your boy. Everybody knows he's not a game or a toy. I'm with you every step of the way. Jesus Christ is the love child. He's the way, the truth, the life. He's... Why are you waving the baby? Check it out. Stop that sin, he won't let it slide. Get on the holiness train and ask the Lord, would you let me ride? Hey, going real swell. I'm going to heaven and not hell. Make some noise, man. Y'all crazy. Man, that was fun. Wait. Don't forget what the point was. The enemy is only subject to the anointing. I never got to the scripture. Yeah, I got to it. So then seven sons of Sceva took it upon themselves. Seven preachers who wear five-piece suits but have no oil took it upon themselves. And there was a man, one man, seven of them, one of them, one man. And they said, "We cast you out, devil, by the name of Jesus who Paul preaches. They didn't even know him for themselves. They piggybacking off of Paul's oil. The devil was like, holla, 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 holla. Let me get this straight. Y'all trying to cast me out. Now, Paul, I know him. And Jesus, I know him too. Who? I wish I had some owls in here. Who are you? And then proceeded to beat the living religion out of them. And they left there naked and bleeding. Why is that important? God did two things. I'm letting you know when you leave, you weren't covered. And the blows you took, your blood is spilling. But when you are anointed, it's the blood of Jesus. They were naked and bleeding, but when you're anointed, you can tell a devil, come out of there. And it has to bow down because my anointing gives me the right to declare the word of God. Is there anybody that takes the anointing over talent, the anointing over gift? Last point. Be loyal to the oil. Where is Heather Montgomery? If she's here, somebody. She on the other side? Oh, she went to youth. She with her husband. Okay. Somebody tell her I want a special hoodie. Oh, she came in. My God. Heather, I want a special limited edition hoodie. I'm going to help design it. It's going to say, be loyal to the oil. Be loyal to the oil. I feel something on it. And it's not going to be regularly priced because the proceeds from that are going to go to help our kids and our elderly and our widows, okay? Somebody say, be loyal to the oil. John chapter 6, verses 68 and 69. This is after Jesus preached the most difficult message he ever preached. He said, you got to eat my flesh and drink my blood unless you have no part in with me. And so the 68th verse, but because the Bible says many of the people who were following Jesus began to leave. And he looked at the disciples and said, y'all leaving too? He wasn't mad because, see, when you're anointed, you don't care who leaves. I'm gonna say that again. When you're anointed, you don't care who leaves. But when you're operating in your flesh, you get insecure. My members were where? They went to see who? I'm calling them. How you doing, Sister Johnson? Didn't see you this morning, but I saw your car over at First Baptist. Well, you're a stalker and a weirdo that you riding past other church parking lots to see your members' cars. First of all, they're not your members because you didn't die for nobody. You are an under shepherd. Everybody belongs to God. That's why this church is safe. I love you, but if you leave, you go wherever God is sending you or go wherever you need to be fed. I'm only preaching to the people who are assigned to my life. I ain't trying to grow no church. I'm trying to build disciples. If you build disciples, the church will invariably grow. 68 and 69 verse, but Simon answered Jesus, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Also, we have come to believe and know that you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. What Peter was saying is, I'm loyal to the oil. I know y'all called Thomas Doubting Thomas, but when Jesus was getting ready to go into Jerusalem, In John 11, when he was getting ready to heal Lazarus, Thomas said, let us go with him so we may die too. What he was saying is, I'm willing to die for this. I'm loyal to this oil. Be loyal to the anointing, not to a person. Listen to what I'm saying. Because blind loyalty to people who are not anointed will cause you to not only fall away and fall out of place, but you'll lose heart when you see the humanity of people who were never called. See, you've got to ask God to give you an understanding of the anointing. That's why the ephod and the breastplate and the turban and all of the ornamentation of the Old Testament priesthood was so important, because God said, I don't want you ministering to me with the possibility of your nakedness showing. And then I want a bell and a pomegranate, a bell and a pomegranate, a bell and a pomegranate. And then I want you to have a gold breastplate, a nameplate that says holiness to the Lord on your turban. And then I want the ephod to be like this, and I need it to be sewn like this. And I need the art of the apothecary. And so I need acacia and stacte and galbanum, and I need myrrh and frankincense and the oil. And it has to be a certain amount in a certain way, because you don't play with God's things. And so you're loyal to the oil, not a person, because a person is not God. But you should be loyal to who God has anointed. What does that mean? David had some mighty men. They went through hell with him. They went to heaven with him. But they stayed. They were loyal because they knew God put his hand on him. Oh, come on, stand up. I'm gonna let you go. Come on, stand up. Come on, stand up. I love y'all. David inspired loyalty because of what he was willing to do. I'm willing to die for anybody in this room. That's why he made me the shepherd. Because shepherds die for the sheep if they have to. But before I die, I'm fighting. I'm going to stab everything that I can that's trying to hurt you. David was like, I killed a lion, killed a bear. He said, I'm going to kill this Philistine just like I killed them. Because he had a shepherd's heart. Make sure, man of God, in all your days, wherever you and your beautiful family go, make sure you identify the anointing, not talent, not gift, not what's cool, not what's popular, not what's popping. Because I can promise you, what's popping today will be gone tomorrow. Be loyal to the oil. Peter said, where am I going? You got the words of eternal life. I also have come to believe and know that you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. And so I say to you all in this moment, have you checked the oil? Revival's about to hit Greenville. And this is the perfect place for it. I prophesied this 3 years ago. One day, a service is going to start, and it's not going to stop. Remember, I said that. It's going to happen, but you can't schedule it. You don't schedule a move of God. That's why it's a move of God. Have you all gotten something out of this message today? What was the title of the message? So at least you can get that part right if they ask you. What he talking about? Oil check? It was an oil check. Well, what was he talking about? He's talking about making sure you go and get oil for your car because you don't want to drive on 85. But no, sir. Sit down, sir. Don't forget the points. There are people that men appoint, and there are people who God anoints. Number two, the anointing does not address character. Number three, talent and gifts are not the same as the anointing. Because talent don't break no yokes. The enemy is only subject to the anointing. He has to bow when the oil is present. And number five, your loyalty is not to an individual. Your loyalty is to the living God. Be loyal to the oil. Be loyal to the anointing. And then be loyal to the one that God has anointed for that season. Amen. Father, seal this word and bless your people in Jesus' holy anointed name. Now, if you're here and you need to go on and stop playing with Jesus and get saved, come down here now. Or if you know this is the place where you need to lock in and be loyal and come and be a part of what God is doing, you and your family come down here right now. I'm just waiting on the first person to move. When the first person moves, other people are gonna move. I bet if you clap, they will come. Come on, y'all. Y'all can do better than that. Somebody else needs to make a move. Somebody else needs to make a move. And even if they're not moving, you all keep clapping to encourage your new brothers and sisters. God did today. If you're online and you want to be a member, text the word member to 95555. 95555. I want all of you to pray with me, okay? And everybody here, we're going to pray together. Let's pray it. Lord Jesus, it's me. I confess with my mouth and believe in my heart that Jesus is Lord. Thank you for the blood that was shed for me. I receive the free gift of salvation, not through my works, but the finished work of the cross. The blood is enough to pay for all my sins. Now, Holy Spirit, come live inside and teach me how to be more like Jesus each and every day. You are my Savior and my Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on, let's celebrate our family. Listen. Normally we have you guys go out, but today you're gonna stay here. Which way are they going, Pastor? Stay right here. Say again. All right, so here's what I'm gonna do. Y'all gonna stay right here. I'm getting ready to do the benediction. So that means everybody else gets to go, but we're going to take a few minutes to get information from you. I see you with the fresh Jordan hat. Still got the label on the top. I see what you're doing. Still got the tag on there. Ballin'. Saw the tag. No, it's too late. Leave it on there. $36.99. Mm-hmm. Have you been blessed today? Listen, this Wednesday kicks off Women's Month, and we gonna have a women's preaching. Women's. Aventer Gray will be bringing the word this Wednesday. Service begins at 7:00 on the dot. I'm in my drop top cruising the street. Sorry, it was too easy. So let me pray for you. Father, bless Relentless Church all over the world. Cover their families. And may the Lord bless you and keep you. Cause his face to shine upon you. May the Lord our God be gracious to you, show you his favor, and give you his peace. I love y'all. I will see you guys Wednesday. Let me ask y'all, who's gonna get a Be Loyal to the Oil hoodie? So that means we need to get like 1,000 of them. Limited edition. You want the shirt? Yeah, because it's about to be summer. Oh, so we can't do hoodies. We got to do shirts. Both? Yeah, they want both. Two? Both of them? Lightweight hoodies? Okay. I love y'all. Go out to the lobby, volunteer, get in the game. Love y'all, rock family, and have an amazing Sunday. You all stay right here. Love y'all.